Hello, this is Lazarus at telecomTech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining OSPF network types. Now, very quickly, free 27-page networking professionals career roadmap. The link is below. Check out my website for more goodies and in-depth courses, and subscribe, like, and hit the bell icon. So what are OSPF network types? An OSPF network type is a parameter that you configure on an interface that is participating in OSPF. The network type you configure will affect how OSPF will behave. This diagram here shows all of the possible configurations you can apply to the Gigabit Ethernet 00 interface for the purpose of allowing OSPF to operate differently. The network types that are available are broadcast, non-broadcast, point-to-point, point-to-multipoint, and point-to-multipoint non-broadcast. Let's focus on the purpose of these commands. OSPF relies on multicast in order for various functions that are critical to its operation to take place successfully. This includes DRBDR elections, neighbor adjacencies, sending update messages, and so on. OSPF uses these particular multicast addresses primarily for the initial establishment of adjacencies and for further operation. However, not all network infrastructures support multicast. OSPF must thus be configured to adjust the way it operates in order to function correctly on such topologies. For example, frame relay, serial links, DMVPN, X25, and ATM are just some technologies that require OSPF to tweak the way it works so that it will operate correctly. Because these technologies either don't support multicast or they emulate multicast in specific ways that may not be compatible with OSPF by default. Even the type of topology, such as point-to-point or point-to-multipoint, like a hub-and-spoke topology, for example, will affect your choice of OSPF network type. So the combination of the underlying network technology as well as the topology will determine the network type that you need to use for OSPF to work. Let's take a look at the specific network types that OSPF supports and explain how these are used. Let's start with the broadcast network type. This network type is likely the most common one you'll use in modern networks. The broadcast network type is the default for an OSPF-enabled Ethernet interface. Now, don't confuse the term broadcast here with what OSPF actually does. OSPF uses multicast and or unicast to send its messages. It never uses broadcasts. However, the term broadcast here refers to the capabilities of the network technology. The broadcast network type requires that the link supports broadcast and, by extension, multicast communication. Now, each network type also has some default behaviors as far as the hello and dead timers go, as well as whether or not DRBDR elections take place, and if so, how they take place. For a broadcast network type, the default timer values are 10 seconds for hello interval and 40 seconds for the dead timer. And finally, an OSPF broadcast network type requires the use of a DR and BDR, which are automatically elected using the DR-BDR election process that we've already talked about. Now, so far, this sounds just like the OSPF operation that we've talked about in previous videos. And indeed, since we haven't been changing the network type in our previous videos, this is the default behavior of the protocol on Ethernet interfaces, which is what we have been using until now. Let's take a look at the other network types. Specifically, let's look at the non-broadcast network type. Now, its correct full name is non-broadcast multiple access, or NBMA. This network type is for those technologies that don't support broadcast and thus don't support multicast. These technologies are still multiple access, which means that you can have more than just two devices on the network, as shown here. But because multicast isn't supported, we need a different way to initially establish our neighbors. When an interface is configured as non-broadcast, OSPF neighbors will not be established automatically. They must be manually configured. This is done using the neighbor command under the OSPF configuration mode as shown. This must be done on both sides of the link so that the OSPF neighbor adjacency can be established. Secondly, OSPF will not send any messages until the neighbor adjacency is actually manually configured and established. All OSPF messages are sent as unicast messages based on the neighbor IP that has been configured in the neighbor command. And this network type has a default of 30 seconds for the hello and 120 seconds for the dead timer. The network topology that is used here is typically a hub and spoke topology. And in such cases, we need the hub of the topology to always play the role of the DR. Thus, you must configure any spokes with a priority of zero, so they don't become the DR or BDR. And only the hub will have a priority of something other than zero. This will result in the hub becoming the DR, and there will actually be no BDR on such a topology. Now, a non-broadcast network is a network type that is typically used for the physical interfaces of a frame relay topology, but it can also be used for other non-broadcast multi-axis networks such as DMVPN or even a hub and spoke IPsec VPN setup. Now let's go on to our next network type. Here we have point-to-point. Now this is used between two directly connected routers, regardless of the underlying communication technology used. What do I mean? Well, you can configure this on Ethernet links, for example, and it will work, assuming you have only two devices on the link. But for technologies such as serial connections, as shown here, the network type is mandatory, and indeed, you'll find that it is set by default. Now, point-to-point means that there is only one device on the other end. So even if you send multicast messages to attempt to create an adjacency, the message will be received on the other end. As such, neighbors are established automatically. A point-to-point OSPF network type does not maintain DR-BDR roles. You don't need these roles because there are, by definition, only two routers. DR-BDR elections have meaning only if you have three or more OSPF neighbors on a single network segment, which isn't the case here. The point-to-point network type has a default hello timer of 10 seconds and 40 seconds for the dead timer. And point-to-point network types are intended to be used between two directly connected routers. Some technologies require it, such as serial links, while other technologies can support it, but may support other network types too. Now, the point-to-multipoint network type is designed for hub and spoke topologies, where the hub can reach all spokes, but the spokes do not necessarily have direct communication between them. The specifics of this network type include the following. OSPF treats point-to-multipoint networks as a collection of point-to-point links, so much of what happens in the point-to-point network type also takes place in point-to-multipoint network types. Like our point-to-point network, this network type also sees only one device on the other end of each individual link. So neighbors are established automatically using multicast. Point-to-multipoint networks do not maintain DR-BDR roles for the same reason as point-to-point network types, and the point-to-multipoint network type has a 30-second hello and 120-second dead timer intervals by default. Examples of technologies where this network type is used is with frame relay, for example, with the broadcast keyword set for frame relay maps. This essentially makes frame relay emulate multicast by sending out multiple unicast messages over each individual link. DMVPN is also a technology that would use this network type. And finally, we come to our last OSPF network type, which is the point-to-multipoint non-broadcast. Now, this network type is used in point-to-multipoint topologies, just like the previous network type, but this time without the support for multicast. That's why we have the non-broadcast keyword here. So everything is really the same as the point-to-multipoint, but it doesn't support multicast. Therefore, it requires a static neighbor configuration. And again, because such a topology is treated as a collection of point-to-point links, there is no need for a DR-BDR election. Hello and dead timers by default are set to 30 and 120 respectively. And this network type is used on hub and spoke technologies where the hub can reach all spokes, but the spokes cannot directly reach each other over the topology. And multicast is not supported. This includes technologies such as frame relay without the broadcast emulation, as well as some DMVPN technologies without multicast support. Now, I know that that's a lot of information to digest, and it won't really become clear unless we actually experiment with it in a lab or in a real-world topology. But the key idea here is that we must choose the network type that fulfills the requirements of our underlying network technology and topology. Now, a final word on network types. It's always important to connect these concepts with real-world scenarios. OSPF network types may not seem as relevant to modern networks, but I assure you that they are. For instance, in data center interconnects and cloud edge deployments, GRE and IPsec tunnels are still widely used to build secure point-to-point links, and OSPF configured with a point-to-point network type ensures stable and efficient routing behavior without the unnecessary overhead of DRBDR elections. Also, in dynamic multipoint VPN deployments, or DMVPN, where spoke routers dynamically form tunnels with a hub and potentially other spokes, OSPF must be adapted to the underlying non-broadcast multipoint GRE topology. Here, the point-to-multipoint non-broadcast type is ideal, especially when multicast isn't supported. Other widely used mechanisms, such as MPLS, SD-WAN, VPLS, VPNs, and many other underlying transport technologies still rely on these network types to get OSPF to work. The key takeaway is this: understanding OSPF network types is more than just academic. They're vital for adapting the OSPF routing protocol to the nuances of the transport medium, whether you're working with MPLS, VPNs, SD-WAN overlays, or cloud hybrid links. Choosing the right network type ensures proper neighbor formation, optimized convergence, and a resilient OSPF design. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. Please check out my website and register for my newsletter. You'll find all the links in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.